So hello everyone, I'm Anindita Rudita and I'm working with Climate Bridge Fund Secretariat as the Manager Operations. And today I will be briefly sharing the mechanism of the Climate Bridge Fund and also some of our learnings so far. I will start with the background and some of the key information about the fund. So the discussions and efforts started back in 2015 between BRAC and KfW to establish a sustainable trust fund. It took around 4 years to put the thoughts into papers. Finally, CBF was established on November 2019. CBF is an innovative, first of its kind in the non-government sector of Bangladesh, a direct climate finance mechanism. We support only the registered NGOs of Bangladesh to address the climate-induced migration-related problems and challenges. Our three priority areas are among the climate hotspots of Bangladesh. We are currently covering 5 cities, including 3 city corporations and 2 municipality areas of Bangladesh. We have a diverse stakeholders engaged with Climate Bridge Fund in different capacities, which include both government and non-government stakeholders and also the communities. We have a flexibility to fund a wide range of sectoral projects, but our key priorities include water, sanitation and hygiene, livelihood support, health support, housing related support, food security, and so on. In this slide, you can see the approaches that we follow or the features of Climate Bridge Fund awarded projects. First up, we have local ownership. And we always promote local ownership as projects are developed in consultation with local government institutes. And we always follow and honor their plans and policies. So the next approach that we have is bottom-up approach, and to ensure that communities are consulted during project development. Our projects are mostly community-led, so their needs and priorities are continuously collected from the field and reflected adequately throughout the project cycle. Next, we have innovative practice, and we always promote innovative but context-specific effective ideas. Then gender inclusion is a major criteria for all our projects. And we also focus on bridging short-term to sustainable model as we fund 3 to 5 years long projects. Then last, we have knowledge and evidence. One of our key focuses is to create good examples through our projects and share the knowledge and learning with external stakeholders. So how CBF is unique? Well, we believe that it is in many ways, though we have only passed 1.5 years and still long way to go, but some of our mechanisms and approaches that proved to be successful so far, which gave us the confidence to call it so. And we would love to hear from you about your thoughts as well. So we look, if we look through the lens of the 8 principles for our locally led adaptation to see where CBF stands. So first of all, as mentioned earlier, that we promote local decision-making process by consulting both communities and local government institutes from the very beginning of the projects. So the need and priorities of the field is always collected and reflected in the project cycle. Then our main target group is climate migrants, as I have already mentioned, but we also include other excluded groups such as women, youth, displaced people, etc. Next up, our funding mechanism is very quick, as it takes around 6 months from proposal submission to the first disbursement, according to our operation manual. And we try to support the local NGOs to ensure their funding security. In case of the international NGOs, who, if they are the applicant, then we encourage partnership with local NGOs. CBF projects implement through the community-based committees, as I have already mentioned, that their capacity building of community is one of our inbuilt mechanisms for all the projects. Then we have building a robust understanding of climate risk and uncertainty. We do not only focus on the skill development of the community, but also on their knowledge enhancement on climate risks, so that they have a clear and better understanding of the problem. Then we follow a very flexible programming method, as we are new and we constantly learn and adapt new effective measures throughout our project cycle. Then transparency and accountability. So it is very important for us, and I would like to give you a quick idea about how we ensure that in the evaluation process. So Climate Bridge Fund Secretariat, they basically evaluate the proposals and prepare the evaluation report, which they eventually present to the advisory committee. The advisory committee members are mainly different experts in the sector, and also we have three representatives from different relevant government offices. Then the secretariat, that's no objection from KFW on the recommendation of the advisory committee. Finally, the trustee board, which is chaired by the executive director of BRAC, takes the final decision based on the recommendation of the advisory committee and no objection from KFW. So all the information are always shared with the management committees very transparently, and we are always accountable to them. So the journey of CBF. To summarize our journey, I would like to say that our journey includes ensuring an institutionally led process. So Climate Bridge Fund, as you already know, has been institutionalized through BRAC and KFW, and we follow all the policies of BRAC. CBF also honors the policies and plans of the local government institutes and uphold those during their project designing. Then partnership is one of our strongest suit of Climate Bridge Fund functionality and governance. From the very beginning, as it is established on the successful partnership between KFW and BRAC. Then in order to operationalize the secretariat, we had series of meetings with the government offices, and their suggestions always helped us. Also, we have launched 3 calls so far and completed 2 batch of evaluation already. And our evaluation process is quite long and rigorous, but this process itself enhanced our skills and knowledge about the reality and facts of the fields. And last up, our journey includes challenges. As you know, that there are always challenges in trying out something new. One of the main challenges were COVID-19 pandemic, the 2020 evaluation process and the project implementation, everything were badly affected by the series of the lockdowns and movement restrictions throughout the country. But we tried to overcome those challenges by adopting new measures and modalities of working. Then another challenge that we faced is that while the fund was established, there was around 10% tax on the investment amount, which is now increased up to 30% under the new law. So CBF is trying to find a way out through the support of the BRAC management and government representatives. So that is an ongoing process for us now. And that brings us to my last slide, which is the recommendation to the task force. And we have 2 recommendations, which we think are very important. The first is that project selection and disbursement process should be quick and easy. The reason we say that is because during our consultation with city authorities and the communities, we came to know about the huge needs of climate migrants. Now, if the gap between the proposal submission and the funding is long, then the context changes and so that the needs. So it should be quick and easy. So another recommendation from us is that during our evaluation process, we found out that local NGOs often fall behind in the competitive process of funding for local, competitive process of securing funding. So we really think that they need to be capacitated as they directly work in the fields and they have better idea about the field realities. So allocating a separate budget for their capacity building will be really helpful in the long run. So that's the end of my presentation. Thank you so much for listening.
Thank you, Anandita, so much for sharing the experience of the Climate Bridge Fund, which I think is extremely innovative, but also very forward-looking because it looks at some of the evolving issues like climate-induced migration, which is a big problem in Bangladesh. But if I can just briefly ask one simple question. We heard about the principles from Suranjana earlier. Now, in terms of the Climate Bridge Fund, what are some of the challenges you think you will face in terms of implementing the fund in the context of those principles? Are there specific principles which you think are more challenging for you to implement? And if so, how you're trying to overcome? And any quick response on that?
Okay, thank you, Arvo. One of the first thing that we have faced as a challenge that I would say is that when a local organization submit their proposals for climate adaptation measures, they often lack the knowledge or the capacity to differentiate between a regular development project and a climate adaptation major focus projects. So we often struggle to evaluate those or score those because there's this huge gap, and we have this process of, you know, continuously talking to them or making them understand the differences during our NGO briefing sessions and different other sessions for their capacity development. So as I have already mentioned, that if they have the basic ideas about what a climate adaptation major focused project should look like, then it would be, you know, good for us to get good projects, and also to it will be a very competitive process, and in the long run, the people who are in the migrants, they will be benefited. So that is one challenge that we are facing currently.